Good morning, students. Welcome back in your SS class. Student, from this video lecture, we will start chapter 4th of civics, that is understanding laws. And this would be the part first of this chapter. Right, students? So before going to start this chapter, first of all, let's discuss the topics which we will cover in this video lecture. First of all, we will discuss about laws. Means what are laws? मीन्स लॉज क्या होते हैं उनके बारे में डिस्कस करेंगे. देन वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट डू दिस लॉज अप्लाई टू ऑल. डू दिस लॉज अप्लाई टू ऑल, वी विल डिस्कस दिस टॉपिक आल्सो. देन वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट हाउ डू न्यू लॉज कम अबाउट. वी विल डिस्कस दिस थिंग एंड आफ्टर देन इन द लास्ट वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट सम अनपॉपुलर लॉ एंड यू कैन से सम कंट्रोवर्शियल लॉज. वी विल फोकस ऑन दिस थिंग्स. राइट फ्रेंड्स? सो स्टूडेंट्स, if I will tell you about laws, so dear student, in our society we have some rule and regulation, and according to these rule and regulation we have to act upon. Means we have to follow all these rule and regulations, and if we will do so, if we will do so, then punishment will be given. Now we have one question here, that why the government has made these type of laws, and why we have to agree upon those things, and why we have to act according to these things. Why? So to understand these questions, we have to study this thing. We have to study this chapter also. So dear student, in our daily life, you may be familiar with different laws, like age of marriages. Means we have one law about the marriage, that the person, means the boy and the girl, it has a standard age, and according to that age, that person can get married. But before that age, no one can be get married. In the, you can say that in the earlier stages, and you can say in the past, we have a social evil, that is child marriage. To stop this thing, the age of the female and male, it has been decided, right? Second one is age of right to vote. Means we all are the citizen of India, and everyone has right to vote without any discrimination. But the age limit, it has been given. Means 18 and above 18, the person can have right to vote, right? So we have a law that determine the age of the right of the voting, right? And second thing, and you can say next thing is also law related to buy and sell the property also. So you have a law, you have familiar with all these type of laws, and even our society we have different type of laws also, and we have come to know about these things, right, students? So here we have one question, that what are these laws? First of all, let's understand the things, that what are these laws. Means ye laws kya hote hain sabse pehle hame pata hona chahiye. So dear student, if we think about laws, these are the system of rule and regulations which a particular country, and you can say community, recognizes as regulating the actions of its member, and which it may enforce by the imposition of the penalties. Means these are the rule and regulation of a country, and you can say of a community, and according to those things we have to act upon. According to those things we have to act upon. These are the. So students, these are the rule and regulation which are recognized in a particular community, and these regulate the action of its member also. Means how do the members act upon it, and how do they behave in the society. These are the rule and regulation which determine these things. And if someone, or you can say that if anyone break these laws, at that situation he was imposition the penalties. It means usse penalties, usse fine provide karna padega. So these are laws. Now my dear student, these laws determines that how a member in the society behave and how he or she would work, right, students? So these are the laws, and these determines the behavior of a person in the society. And if the person do not act upon according to these laws, that person would be punished. Maybe some penalties will be imposed to that particular person, right, students? So these are laws. Hope so this thing is clear to all of you. Now student, we have one important question. Do laws apply to all? This is the most important question before us. We are living in India, and this India, it has a caste-based society where discrimination, you can say, are also seen, were also seen in the past also. So that's why with this question, it is very important for us that do laws apply to all? So let's discuss this thing. So my dear student, as there should be no arbitrary exercise of power in independent India. It means that manmane tarike se. कोई भी जो गवर्नमेंट है इंडिपेंडेंट इंडिया के अंदर वो मनमाने तरीके से अपनी पावर का यूज नहीं कर सकता. नोबडी कैन यूज इट्स पावर इन यू कैन से इन इट्स ओन मैनर. रीजन इज दैट बिकॉज द इंडियन द मेंबर ऑफ द इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन असेंबली दे हैव मेड अ लॉट ऑफ प्रोविजंस इन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन दैट एस्टैब्लिश इन द सोसाइटी रूल ऑफ लॉ दैट एस्टैब्लिश इन द सोसाइटी रूल ऑफ लॉ. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट्स डिस्कस अबाउट रूल ऑफ लॉ. I have told you here that in independent India, no one can use its power in an arbitrary manner. It means that in their own manner, he or she has to act upon according to the provisions of the constitution. And the Constituent Assembly, it has provided some provisions that would establish in our society rule of law. So first of all, let's discuss about what is rule of law. So dear student, if you have this word that rule of law, it means that the law, it is equal, all the person before the law is equal and no one is above the law. This is the meaning of this rule of law. And in our Indian constitution, this provision has been given, and as a fundamental right like right to equality, this provision has been given in that you can say right. So if we think about rule of law, it means all person in independent India, they all are equal before the law. No one is discriminated because I have told you that in our society it is caste based society, and there are many communities who always face you can say in the past who always faced discrimination, right friends? So that's why our Indian constitution makers, they were well aware about this situation. That's why they have put this provision in our Indian constitution, that is rule of law. So according to this concept, all person in independent India, they are equal before the law and no one is above the law, right? So all laws apply equally to all the citizen, apply it to all the citizen of the country, and no one can be above the laws. No one can be above the laws, right students? That means that the law can't discriminate between persons on the basis of their religion, caste and gender. You can see that, right students? So students, our Indian constitution makers, they were well aware about the situation that what is rule and rule of law. So because we are living in the, you can say that caste-based society, and in this society, a section of the society, they always face discrimination. That's why to protect those society, those communities, that's why rule of law, it has been introduced, you can say it has, this provision has been put in the Indian constitution. Right students? So my dear student, we have to act upon according to the laws. If any person can do any crime, means any crime and any violation of the law, it has been seen that then specific punishment has been introduced and specific punishment has been given. Right, students? So whether the person belong to any caste, whether the person belong to any post, it doesn't matter. Everyone is equal before the law. If a common person do any crime, it means punishment will be given to that particular person. And if the president of India, he will do any crime, then punishment is given at the same manner, right friends? So that's why this rule of law, this provision has been put in the Indian constitution, so that the discrimination can be sorted out and the discrimination can be over, right friends? And my dear student, if we think about our past, in the ancient time of India, there were many, and you can say there are many people who always overlap the local laws. And you can say that the laws, whatever are prepared at that time, they were not apply at the same manner, not in equal manner. You can say that the punishment for the same crime, it varied depending upon the caste background, depending upon the particular person. So that's why to see this situation in the past, that's why our Indian constitution makers, they were know about this situation. That's why they have put this rule of law in our fundamental rights, so that the law would be applied to all people. Right, students? Hope so this thing is clear to all of you. Now let's think further about many things also. Member of the Indian Constituent Assembly, they were agreed there should be no arbitrary exercise of power in independent India. Means कोई भी independent India के अंदर मनमाने ढंग से कोई भी अपना power का misuse ना करे. So to establish a law, they instituted several provisions in the Constitution. They instituted several provisions in the Indian Constitution, and according to those provisions, you have to act upon. Right, students? And if we think about this rule of law in India, the British colonialist, they introduce also this thing in India also. But our historian, they have disputed about this claim, that many people believe that the rule of law, this situation, this provision, it has been introduced in our India by the British government. But our historian have disputed against this thing. Reason is that they have given a lot of examples, and those examples shows that the colonial laws, they were arbitrary. They were arbitrary also. And the Indian nationalist, they played an important role in the development of this legal sphere. The Indian nationalist, they played an important role. After then, the British government tried to establish this rule of law. But if we think about it, that British government, it has introduced this rule of law automatically, it does, you can say it seems a negative thing. Right, thing? The British law of the Sedition Act of 1870, it set a perfect example of the arbitrariness, right? The British law of the Sedition Act of 1870, it is a set of perfect example of the arbitrariness. According to this act, a person protesting or you can say criticizing the British government, he or she could be arrested without any trial, just only on the basis of doubt. Just only on the basis of doubt, that person would be arrested because he was thought that particular person is the political activist, and he would sent jail for 2 years. This act was known as the Roulette Act also. In 1919, British government established this law, and you can say passed this law. And according to this law, a person who appeared. So dear student, so this is the example. This is the example of that the British colonial period, under the British colonial period, law was, you can say, in arbitrary manner. So this act, that is known as a Roulette Act, and you will study about it in the next class also, in the 12th chapter of this class also. Right, friends? So this act shows that how colonial period misused the power also. Right, friends? So whenever this law was passed, the Indian nationalists, they began protesting and criticizing this arbitrary use of the authority by the Britishers, and even they began to fight for the greater equality, and they wanted to change the idea of law from a set of rules that were forced to obey to law as including an idea of justice. So that's why Indian nationalists, they began protesting against all these laws, and due to this pressure, the government has to change their policies also. Right, friends? Hope so this thing is clear to all of you. Now, student, but by the end of 19th century, the Indian legal profession began emerging, and they demanded respect in the colonial court also by using laws to defend the legal rights of the Indian also. Even Indian judges, they began to play a greater role in the decision making also. So dear student, here I want to tell you one thing, that under the British government, whenever any crime is done by any English member, the decision, and you can say the hearing, it was just done by the judge of the Britishers, not by any Indian judge. It was prohibited. But whenever the whenever in the 19th century protest was there, then Indian judges have got this power also. Right, friends? Then Indian judges, they got also power, this thing, that they could hear the case of the British government also. With the adoption of the constitution, laws for the country began to be made by the representative. Now, the participation of the British, Indian people in the council election, it has been increased. So that's why when the constitution was adopted, so the laws, they were made by the representative. Oh, wow. Means representative, they made law, it means laws are become a more fair manner. Right, friends? So every year, representative passed new laws and as well as they started to revise the existing ones. Means जो पहले बने थे उनको revise भी करने लगे. For example, Hindu Succession Amendment Act 2005. It's very most important law. And according to this law, son and daughter and their mother, they have same equal share of the family property. Means before the 2005, it was suggested that the right on the property, it was just only the son of that particular area. But according to this law, son, daughter, as well as their mother also, they have equal share of family property. Right, so that's why the representative they pass new laws with the passage of time, and as well as they also revise the previous laws also. If there may be some, you can say that some problem in those laws also. Right, friends. Hope so. This thing is clear to all. Now we have next question that how do new laws come about? So dear student, we will study this thing in the next class. Right, students, hope so everything is clear to all of you. So I'll see you in the next video. Thank you. Have a nice day.